Hello students, in previous lecture we had seen the introduction to web technologies, then basic terms, website, internet, protocol, etc., various softwares for creating website, qualities of good website, etc. In this presentation, I am going to teach you client server and its communication, internet protocols and various client and server scripting languages. Consider client server and its communication. Consider what is client and what is server. I will say that server is nothing but the provider of a resource or the service. Okay? And service requester, that is client. Right? So there are two components, as I told, client and server. There are various or multiple clients in the communication with a single server. As shown in the figure, you can see that there are n number of clients which are connected to the server, and clients will send the request to the server and server will respond to the request of the client. There are various applications that use client server model, like email, network printing and World Wide Web. Now, to understand the communication between client and server, we should understand some basic topics like request, response and service. Consider request. So requests are sent from client to ask the server for some data like files, or tell the server about the things that happen, like that a user want to log in with his credentials, right? Next is response. So response is sent from server to the client, and it is the reaction of server to a request of the client, right? This could, for example, be an authentication result. Next is the service. So service is nothing but a specific task that server provides for the client to use, like for example downloading the image, right? So on the basis of these three concepts, like request, response and service, we can say that clients and server exchange the messages in request response messaging pattern. The client sends a request, the server returns a response. This exchange of messages is the example of IPC, that is inter-process communication. So for the communication, the computers must have a common language and they must follow the rules so that both the client and server know what to expect. Okay, the language and rules of communications are nothing but protocol. So which formally defines the rules, languages and dialogue patterns to be used. Client-server communication typically uses TCP/IP protocol suite. So a server may receive requests from many different clients in a short period of time. A computer can only perform limited number of tasks at any moment and relies on scheduling system for prioritizing incoming requests from the clients for accommodating with them. TCP protocol will maintain a connection until the client and server have completed their message exchange. Now, the TCP protocol will determine the best way to distribute the application data into packets that the networks can deliver. Transfer the packet to and receive the packet from network. And it will manage flow control and retransmission of dropped packets. We will see the details of TCP IP protocol in next slides. IP is a connectionless protocol in which each packet traveling through the internet is an independent unit of data unrelated to any other data unit. Now there are various types of servers and they are classified by the services that they provide. For example, a web server serves the web pages and file server serves the computer files. Now consider what is client and server scripting languages. The scripts can be written in two forms, at the server end, that is backend, or at the client end or server end. The main difference between server side scripting and client side scripting is that the server side scripting involves server for its processing. On the other hand, client side scripting requires browser to run the scripts on the client machine but does not interact with the server while processing the client side scripts. Now, server side scripting is a technique of programming for producing the code which can run software on the server side. In simple words, we can say that any scripting or programming that can run on the web server is known as server side scripting. The operations like customization of website or dynamic change in the website contents, response generation to the user's queries, accessing the database, and so on are the various tasks that are performed at the server end. Now, there are various server-side scripting languages. Various server-side scripting languages are PHP, Python, Perl, ASP.NET, Java, Ruby, etc. Client-side scripting, as the name suggests, is performed to generate a code that can run on the client end or browser without needing the server-side processing. Basically, these types of scripts are placed inside the HTML document. Client-side scripting can be used to examine the user's form for the error before submitting it and for changing the contents according to the user input. Okay? The effective client-side scripting can reduce the server load. It is designed to run as a scripting language utilizing web browser as a host program. There are various client-side scripting languages like HTML, CSS, JavaScript, VBScript, Ajax, jQuery, etc. As we have HTML, CSS and JavaScript in detail in next chapters, so I would like to give a little introduction about this client-side scripting languages. So HTML, it is the fundamental building block of the web programming, which provides the frame to the websites. It describes the arrangement of the contents of the website. CSS, that is cascading style sheet, provides the way to design the graphic element, which will help in making the appearance of web application more attractive. And JavaScript is also client-side scripting language that is devised for the specific purpose, but there are various JavaScript frameworks used as a server-side scripting technology also. Now consider, how does the internet work? The internet works through a packet routing network in accordance with IP, that is Internet Protocol, and TCP and other protocols. We have already considered what is protocol. So it is a set of rules specifying how the computers should communicate with each other over the network. For example, TCP has a rule that if one computer sends data to another computer, the destination computer should let the source computer know if any data was missing so the source computer can resend it, right? Or the Internet Protocol, which specifies how computers should route information to other computers by attaching the addresses onto the data that it sends. Now, what is internet addresses? Now, because the internet is a global network of computers, each computer connected to the internet must have a unique address. The addresses range are in the range of 0 to 255, and these addresses are known as IP address. Now, when you are connected to the internet, your computer has a unique IP address. There are n number of various internet protocols. We will see the very basic protocols like IP, HTTP and FTP. Consider internet protocol, that is IP. Internet protocol is a connectionless and unreliable protocol. It ensures Why it is called as unreliable? Because it ensures no guarantee of successful transmission of data. It makes no guarantee that packets will always arrive at their destinations. When that happens, it is called as a packet loss. This typically happens when the router receives more packets it can process. It has no option other than to drop some packet. However, the TCP protocol will handle the packet loss by performing retransmission. Now, why retransmission is required? Because that packet is lost. It has not reached to the destination. So it has to be retransmitted, and TCP will do that retransmission. It does this by having the destination computer periodically send acknowledgement packet back to the source computer, and that will indicate how much of the message it has received and reconstructed. If the destination computer finds there are missing packets, it sends a request to the source computer asking it to resend a missing packet. Now, to make it reliable, it must be paired with TCP, as we have discussed. The data sent across the internet is called as message. Now, before this message is sent, it is first split into many fragments, and that is called as packets. These packets are sent independently of each other, and as we have said, to make it reliable, it must be paired with TCP. Next is file transfer protocol, that is FTP. It is a standard internet protocol used for transmission of files between computers on the internet over TCP/IP connections. It is a client-server protocol where a client will ask for a file and local or remote server will provide it. The end user machine is typically called as local host machine, which is connected through the internet to the remote host, which is the second machine running FTP software. Client initiates the conversation with server by requesting to download a file. Using FTP, client can upload, download, delete, remove, move, copy, rename files on a server. User typically needs to log on to FTP server. So FTP is used to copy the files from one host to another. It offers the mechanism for the same in the following manner. It creates the two processes, like control process and data transfer process, at both ends, that is at the client as well as at the server. Then it establishes two different connections, one for data transfer and other is for control information. It uses port 21 for the control connection and port 20 for the data connection. Next is HTTP, that is Hypertext Transfer Protocol. It is a communication protocol which defines mechanism for communication between browser and the web server. It is also called as request and response protocol because the communication between browser and server takes place in request and response pairs. Now consider about HTTP request. It is comprised of lines that contains request line, header fields, and message body. Now the first line, that is the request line, specifies the request method, that is get or post. The second line specifies the header, which indicates the domain name of the server from where index.html is retrieved. Now consider about HTML response. Like HTTP request, HTTP response also has certain structure. It contains status line, header, and message body. HTTP is application level protocol foundation for data communication for World Wide Web. It is also a stateless protocol. It is TCP/IP based communication protocol used for delivering the HTML files, image files, client request on World Wide Web. default port used is TCP/AT, but other ports also can be used. It provides a standardized way for computers to communicate with each other. So we have seen all the three basic protocols, that is IP, FTP, and HTTP. Thank you.